I like video games, but I really like anime, and I really like it when the two worlds collide, and that's what we have today in Tokyo Mirage Sessions FE. So for all of you that don't know, this game is a crossover of the Fire Emblem world and the Shin Megami Tensei world. It is everything I've wanted and more. It's pure anime bullshit. It has stuff about the idol industry in it, and when I'm not playing like proper games, I'm on my phone either playing Side M, N Stars, or Love Live School Idol Festival, so this is everything. As soon as we start the game, we already see the idol influence. It doesn't say new game. It says debut. My favorite thing about this intro segment is that this game involving magic and creatures and different dimensions feels the need to warn us that it's fiction. I know. We're not all stupid. Just include that in the stupid people's games. Just tax the stupid people. So we have this cutscene in the beginning, and this girl is like seeing this play. We're not really sure who this girl is, but this girl is specifically highlighted, and then people on the stage and in the audience begin to start to disappear, just like everyone in my life. A mysterious light saves this girl, but I can't help but wonder, where are her parents? Her parents must be gone as well. She must be just fucked. Like, she's alone. She has nothing. We have shots of a series of specific characters, so I'm going to assume they're the main cast. I actually went into this game without knowing anything about it. I just kind of saw the box art and went, yoink. We start playing as Itsuki, a character that proves that I have the same face as every anime protagonist ever. No, seriously, look it up. I'm not joking. Our friend is late, so we begin wandering all alone, which just makes me think that this game is very, very, very true to my life. I want friends. We can actually begin to wander around and talk to NPCs, and there's this guy that only likes anime girls, and I agree, personally, I only like
sexy anime boys, I like them sexy anime boys. Sexy anime boys, I like them sexy anime.
So from what I can gather, we're at some kind of idol audition, and everyone's really, really excited to be there because, well, they might get to become an idol, and it's being done in this weird X Factory, America's Got Talent, Britain's Got Talent kind of style. Then we run into intro girl, Tsubasa, and she's really shocked to see us, actually. There's this idol that she's obsessed with, and we're like, I don't care, I don't care. And then she's on to us, abort, abort, abort. She actually blackmails us into listening to this idol, otherwise we have to buy her a parfait. Oh, it's so anime, I wanna die. We then ask her what she's up to and she pulls this face. The only time that face is publicly acceptable is if you're at a sushi buffet and you do not know where to start. It's then announced that the idol applicants then have to gather and she has to mysteriously leave to do something. Also, who is the sexy poster man? Sir, can I have your number? Can you be my boyfriend? Sir? We then go to check out the audition and what the fuck was that? Does no one look in mirror? Personally, I look in mirrors, and if I saw that following me, I would just be like, peace out, bye. Suddenly the auditions for this idol thing become the finals, and who's on stage but Tsubasa? Then that thing that followed us in is behind you. Oh no, never mind, it's gone, carry on. Because Tsubasa, it probably isn't going to win, she ends up pulling out a sob story. So it turns out that all the disappearing people actually took place 5 years ago, and Tsubasa's sister was actually on stage, and she was the one of the people that went missing. The reality TV show wants to exploit this situation, and the man that works in reality TV is evil. I'm so shocked, like, wow. People in reality TV are evil and want to exploit your personal pain. Who would have known? Tsubasa gets captured, so we run after her. We go to this mystery world, and the physical manifestation of Moe actually tells us where to go. We then have an animated cutscene, and it's revealed we have protagonist plot point powers. Then we have saved Tsubasa, and we've turned two of the bad guys good, and somehow our characters knew to fusion digivolve with the now good bad guys. I'm very confused. There's actually no way for me to rip on the battle system. I find it incredibly fun. It's the exact same battle system found in the Persona games. And that's when Itsuki finally asks, what the fuck is going on? In real life, in a situation where you're surrounded by a bunch of potential murderers and no one knows what's going on, you're probably gonna die. We get a text from our friend telling us how to get out of this mysterious world, but we're not questioning how he knows anything. Like, in real life, I'd be like, how the fuck do you know where I am? This is a mysterious world filled with ghosts, monsters, and Digimon, and somehow I can now fusion Digivolve. What the fuck? Then we have to fight the guy in a suit. I wish that was my first time saying that I had to fight a guy in a suit, but honestly, I work in show businesses, and this is a dog-eat-dog world. And I also don't wear suits. Our friend eventually turns up, and it turns out that he can Digivolve too. The guy in a suit turns into this thing. Why is his head sticking out the top? Am I the only one finding this gross? It's like, you know, in a sausage factory where they just have all the meat turn into like a tube of meat. It sort of reminds me of that. The first boss was honestly very, very easy, and then Toma, our friend, actually explains that we're in a place called the Idolosphere, and he's been doing this for a very, very long time, which is why he's level 4, and we've only just started doing it, and we're level 5. We continue onwards for a bit, but then Kiria turns up to save the day. Seriously, she's Miku. She's Miku. Look at her, she's Miku. Naturally, Tsubasa freaks out because she loves Kiria, and obviously, when you've had to fight for your life multiple times in one day, meeting another human is the part you freak out about. We make it out safe, and this is when we meet Miss Booby Lady. Now, Miss Booby Lady works for Fortuna Entertainment. Turns out Fortuna Entertainment is not only an idol agency, but they also have a bunch of people that can fight these evil beings under them. And that's when our character and Tsubasa join Fortuna Entertainment. It's also very, very briefly explained that those that are good in performing arts and would work in the idol industry are able to work with these beings called Mirages and essentially fusion Digivolve. So you know, my 11 years in performing arts school wasn't a waste, mother! I actually only recorded up to the end of the prologue, but I have played considerably more of the game now. I'm at about 50 hours in and I'm still not finished because there is so much side content in this game. It's honestly the best game I've played in such a long time. I recommend it to everyone that likes JRPGs. It's got the tropes that you love, but it also does a lot of new, really submersive things. I really highly recommend it to anyone out there, regardless of whether you like anime, JRPGs, idols, there is something for everyone and I definitely recommend it. And now onto the giveaway. I'm going to be giving away this Pit Amiibo. So to enter the giveaway, all you have to do is leave a comment down below, be subscribed to this channel, and share this video on any form of social media. It can be Facebook, it can be Twitter, it can be Tumblr, anything you can think of. Just hashtag it Amiibo and then say why you want this Amiibo. Do you use Amiibos? Have you never had an Amiibo before? Just let me know. Honestly, I only recently got into Amiibos, but I have to say I'm really, really enjoying collecting them. They are a lot of fun and they actually do add a level of depth to the games that they're involved in that I would not have expected. But overall, I give Tokyo Mirage Sessions FE a solid 10 out of 10. I'm really, really enjoying the game. My only gripe, really, in reality, as much as I did roast it a bit in this video, is the load times. So I click to start the game, and like many games, we are shown an intro cutscene. Why do all these men look the exact same? Are they Oompa Loompas? Did this game employ Oompa Loompas? And one thing I definitely have to say about this game is that all the British accents are really convincing.
It's amazing, Professor!
Really convincing, like I believe it.
It's amazing, Professor!